This is not actually my paintball bag. This is my son's paintball bag, but if you are looking for a bag and you can find this, this is the GI Sportz Tank’r Bag. It's an old model. I think they had it on sale from A&S Gear. Maybe last Christmas, super discounted. So we got it for a great price, but it's a monster bag. It holds just about everything, built like a tank, and definitely recommend it if you can find it. But let's take a look at my bag. This is my bag. This is a bag that I bought off of eBay for maybe 25 or 30 bucks. And as you can see here, it's already torn, the zipper's torn here, so I'm gonna have to be purchasing a new one. So I'll be checking out a lot of videos myself. But I wanted something that was gonna carry a ton of stuff because my son, my younger son, Colby, is playing on a paintball team. So we're going up to the fields every 2 weeks to have our practices, plus traveling to tournaments and doing all that stuff. We need to make sure we had a lot of room to carry all of our paintball gear. And as you'll see in a second, it really starts to add up fast. So if you need a super cheap paintball bag, then eBay is the place to go. This thing probably would have held up better if I didn't have this thing in here, but we'll get to that in a second. So first off, let's actually move this out of the way. So first off, we've got my original marker, which I purchased off of eBay. When we first got into paintball, eBay was really where I looked to find the deals. And I was able to find this Empire Axe, one of the original models. This is the infamous edition. If you can see that focused there, but it has just really super awesome graphics on this. It came with a standard barrel, so I did end up getting a free kit to go along with it. Actually, quick story, the very first time we went out to the paintball fields, I had this disassembled, and so I really just brought this. I forgot the barrel the very first time that I went out there. So I ended up having to purchase the free kit from the paintball field that we were at. Luckily they had one there and I could use my brand new marker. Also wanted a bag that went with it, so I was able to pick this up off online at eBay as well. Can't remember exactly what this one was called, but it's certainly one of their models that they don't have every year. You know, they have just the random colors, blue, green, red, stuff like that. So when we were getting into it, this is the Bunker Kings 4x7. Now I never carry more than 4 pods. Okay, so let me explain my paintball experience. As I mentioned, my son plays paintball. We go to the paintball fields every 2 weeks to play. That's mostly for their practice. Now I help coach their team. We do play some rec ball on hyperball fields, on mounds fields, a little bit in woods. And you know, when you go out and play rec ball, you're playing against rec ball players, which means they don't usually have this. So you're not often going to need to have 11 pods with you. Now, you can probably see in the background back there, we do have a lot of extra paint left over. We did go to the Invasion of Normandy event this past year, this past summer at Skirmish. Awesome time. Paint is super expensive. And you know, when you go to those things, you're gonna wanna have a lot of these. Also, if you're a tournament player, then you're gonna wanna have a bag that holds more than 2 or 3 or 4 pods. The reason why I went with the Bunker Kings, because it has the padded back here. It tightens up real tight, and the pod holders back here are nice. They're not too tight, but you can get the pods in there and they stay in there. So I never have anything fall out, and also, like I said, I never really do anything with these flaps. So I'm pretty much only carrying 4 there. But this one's been great for me. It's also easy to mark down those hits when you get those. So as I mentioned, we went into Skirmish last year. So for Christmas, I had three of these made for me and my two boys to go and play in the woods because we didn't have anything that was sort of camo colored. This is an anthrax jersey. That's worked out great for me. The jersey that I'm wearing right now is also another jersey that I found on eBay. This is a jersey that I found on eBay. Now, one thing that I will tell you, here's a tip. When I started out, I was looking for really what I wear in shirts. So I bought a medium here. This is a medium paintball jersey. That'll fit you, but really what you're looking for is something bigger. I can't remember what this one is. This one's probably like an extra large. I think I got it for maybe 15 bucks, so I didn't really care what it was. And turns out I really wear this one more than I did this one because oftentimes I was wearing something underneath it. You know, when it starts to get cold, then you want to have other gear there. But again, eBay is your friend when looking for that. Also, shopping for deals. This is a pair of the Empire Contact Zero. I think these are the 15s, 14 or 15. These are very padded, heavily padded. Also, I made a mistake here. I got these in large, size 36 to 38. I have like a 33, 34 inch waist. Again, thinking that this was gonna go to like true waist size and not what you have in your jeans. Anyway, just make sure you do your research in terms of looking at the measurements on all the different websites. Now, here's another pair of pants that I have. These are the carbon pants. I love these pants. These things are ridiculous. Again, I'll leave a link in the description for all this stuff down in the description for exactly what these are. But these are nice and stretchable, okay? And if it's super, super cold outside, I'm gonna wear these. If it's normal to hot, I'm gonna wear these. I would wear these all day, every day. These just provide a little bit more padding in them, so maybe I don't wanna wear knee pads, and I'll just wear these guys, but these are just the bomb. I love, love, love these carbon pants here. Another shirt that I picked out, this is an old Edmonton Impact sleeveless shirt made by, I think that's Raza. Anyway, picked that up off eBay for 15 bucks. Great to wear underneath a jersey for a little bit extra padding, but you can rip this thing off in between points that you're playing, because if you're gonna go play in rec ball fields, then oftentimes you're waiting 30 minutes or so between your matches. And you know, in the summertime, I live in Atlanta, down south, it's hot as snot here. So definitely want to have stuff to manage your heat. Now here I have the Exalt goggle case version 2. So it's the hard case here, and it holds my GI EVS goggles. I can't remember exactly what this color wave is called, but this EVS is the model that the team wears, and I wanted to get this because they have mostly all black. I want to get this so that it stands out when you've got 15 of these sitting around. You can also buy custom little straps. A&S has a ton of different of these. I got a different strap for Colby so he could pick his out. But these have worked out really nicely. I don't really have any issues with fogging. They haven't scratched hardly at all. Now, this is something that we take to the fields with us. We always have this at our tournaments. This is just a plain old spray bottle that I picked up at Home Depot, and I put in a mixture of 50% alcohol and 50% water. So I just bought a big jug of isopropyl alcohol for like $3 at CVS, and I filled up two of these, or you know, half of these, half of it in two of these, so that I had this for the team to be able to use. Now, as you're seeing here, I've got tons of paintball stuff. So the kids on the team sort of make fun of me and call me the team mom, because I always have everything that everybody needs. You're not gonna need all of this stuff. We'll kind of talk about what's sort of the minimum things that you're looking after if you're just getting into paintball. And that's primarily the folks that I anticipate really watching this gear bag video. So you're definitely going to need plenty of wipes. These are microfiber towels. I actually bought a big, huge thing of these. So I got gobs of these left over on Amazon. You can buy them in a 50 pack for, you know, 25 bucks or something like that. And that way, you know, you don't worry about tearing up your mom's towels or your wife's towels or your towels. These are just, you know, super cheap. Throw these in the wash and don't worry about them. Now, here is another tip for you. So this is, let's call it 12 by 10 or so. This is a little hard to stuff in your pocket. So what I did to some of these is I just took a knife to them and tore them up into quarter sheets here. So you can see that. So I give this to my kids and they just throw it in their pocket. And that way, you know, if they're coming up off the field or if they're going onto the field and they forgot to wipe, they can just give a quick wipe on their mask between games, and, or, you know, if they want to wipe a paint shot off of somebody between games, and they can do that. And I find it just handy to have a nice little small one of those around. So definitely have to get your barrel cleaners. These are GIs. I'm sure they're probably made by Exalt. They look just like the Exalt ones. Those are all pretty much the same. You're definitely gonna need to get some of these pods if you're getting a pod pack. So the ones that actually I like the best are these cheap ones from Gen X Global. And the reason why is because they close well. Okay, you can hear that snap. That means that they're closed. And they've got this little pin right here at the edge, this little plastic part that sticks out that you can get your thumb on, and they open nicely. Now, a lot of these pods, and plus you wanna get cheap ones because they're going to break, okay? So you can get these for $1.50 or something like that. Sometimes even one of the fields that I've been to in the past, like if you buy a box of paint, then they'll give you a pod for free, okay? So every once in a while, you know, you'll pick up different ones at the field. This one here is from Vulcan, but it's about the same thing. They're probably all manufactured in the same facility in China somewhere. But anyway, so let's see, what else do we have in here? So barrel plugs, barrel condoms, barrel covers, whatever you wanna call these things, okay? Now, a lot of times when you buy a gun, then you are going to get one of these. As I bought mine from eBay, it didn't happen to have one, but I've gotten a couple different ones. I actually have a different gun that I'll show you later. I actually prefer this kind. I don't know who made this, if this is an HK one or Exalt, but I think it's an Exalt one. They have gobs and gobs and gobs of different colors that are available, and you just put this on the end, wrap it around either in your gun or the hopper or something like that. And the reason why I like these is because they're easier to wash, okay? When you put this on the end of the barrel, if you forget to turn your gun on and you pull a trigger, the ball's gonna go in there. And I can't tell you how many times I do that. I'm very forgetful. So just about every single day, I'm gonna end up with at least one ball in the end of my barrel cover here. So these are plastic, okay? They're super easy to wash. You just hold that under the faucet. You turn it on under there and then just let that air dry. So I do prefer those. And I also recommend that you have several of them, because usually once you shoot a ball into it, then you're just gonna take it off and replace it, because it's hard to wash at the field, and otherwise then you're getting a bunch of paint on the end of your barrel all the time, okay? Here's one from Raza, nice little alien picking his nose. So again, they're only a few bucks. It's nice to have those. Okay, so here's sort of my field kit that I keep a lot of my stuff in. And this is just an old plastic box that I had around the house with all the little things. And these are things that just sort of come in handy at the fields. So this is my Allen wrench set that I primarily use. This is from Bondus, B-O-N-D-H-U-S. This is a Gorilla Grip. I always recommend putting your name on it here, because, you know, this could get left around easily. It's easy to go back to the field and say, hey, they might turn one of these in with Foster on it. You know, there's several different sets of these. This is a dye one that I got on sale. This one includes some additional little accoutrements, a set of, what is this? This includes a screwdriver and a little knife and some other things to help get your O-rings off. This is a nice little thing to have. So now you can start to see why everybody starts to call me the team mom. A little set of pliers. You never know when things are gonna work. So this, all this money that you're gonna spend on buying this fancy, really cool, pretty gun that you're gonna wanna take care of, well, unfortunately, those things break down. You have to make sure that you take care of them. And so all these little tools help to be able to fix it when you're at the field versus driving all the way to the field, then discovering that it doesn't work, or you're there for half the day, you discover that it doesn't work for some reason, and instead of having to go home, you can take 15 minutes to fix it, you can get back on the field and enjoy a couple more hours of play. Okay, so part of the process of taking care of the guns is make sure that when you come home, you're always cleaning the gun and re-lubing it. So there's lots of different types of grease that's out there, and just make sure that you have one that is appropriate for your specific gun. Here's a set of tape. This is just some Gorilla tape. I usually have some Band-Aids stuffed in here, some extra screws. Here is a GoPro mount for one of the guns that I have. Headband to keep my ears warm. So just a little bit of everything in here. Again, I'll show you the links for everything down in the description. So what else we have in here? Toilet wipes always come in handy, okay? You should know what these are for. Extra batteries. This is something that, again, once you get into using electronic gun, electronic hopper, this is something that you're gonna want. So depending on what your gun takes, 9 volts, double A's, triple A's, whatever it is, make sure you have extra of those, okay? Now, these are the cheap ones that I get from Amazon. They're just Amazon basics. If you're super into paintball, then you know those folks are gonna tell you, well, like, get the really expensive Energizer ones. Yeah, okay, you can, or you can get the cheap ones. They work just as well. You just may have to replace them a little bit more frequently. So I like to have these, and another reason I like to have these is because people always ask you for ones. So when you're loaning a battery out at $1 a battery versus loaning a battery out at $6 a battery, it's not as bad. And when I say loan, I mean give. So anyway, extra batteries for that there. Just some extra stuff. Oh, I mentioned that we went to the invasion of Normandy this year, and we were on the German side. The Germans won for the first time in a long time, so really proud of that. Had a ton of fun with that. They put on a first-class event. It's just expensive as crap. You'll see some of that paint back there, that custom paint from GI. That's what we bought there. It was $80 a case. One case, 2,000 balls, $80. Super, super expensive. So here's the team jerseys that we have. I've got a red one and a black one here. Again, I believe these are made by Raza. And I only point this out to show that there is a big difference in paintball jerseys out there. These jerseys, these are part of what we got as part of the Imperial program, I think, through the GI Sports sponsorship. These things are ridiculous. Like, I love this jersey. This one that I have on here is an older one, and you know, I don't know if it was sponsored or what, or exactly who made it, and I didn't care when I bought it because it was just cheap, but it, you know, sort of feels cheap. I don't know if it's just feels like polyester, or if it's just crappy cotton, or whatever it is. But there are differences in paintball jerseys. So once you get into it, take a look around, and in a lot of cases, you do get what you pay for. This was a top-notch jersey that our team wears. So that's pretty much all I have. I've got some other nicks and nacks, some additional batteries, some more pods, more rags in here. Let's see here. Oh, two more things. Sunscreen. Throw in some sunscreen there. You're gonna need it. You may think you're fully covered. You always forget, or I always forget, about the back of my neck. So your special other person, your spouse, your significant other will appreciate it. The other thing is just a cheap little knife. This is super handy for opening the paintball bags, okay? When you're opening a bunch of bags, it just helps save your fingers a little bit. So, you know, I got this knife off of Amazon. I think it was $7, something like that. Also had this little tiny screwdriver at the end, which is like a window breaker or something like that. Nice little thing to have. Actually, I lied. There's a few more things. So, if you've not seen my paintball stand video, I'll link it right up here to how to make this paintball stand. You can make this for under $10. It's just nice to have when you've got everything set up. What else do we have? Elbow pads. When this is more, I'd say, for tournament style players, or, you know, possibly if you're doing a lot of woods ball and you're crawling around on your elbows, sort of sneaking around. I got these from Dye. These are not from Dye. I paid for these. These are Dye's. These are nice. They're comfortable. They're padded. They stay on my arm pretty well. I know some folks have different versions, some other brand names, and they kind of slip down, so they're constantly pulling those up. I don't have any issues with those. I do like those. I picked these up. These are gloves. So again, once it starts to get cold out there, getting shot in your hand is like the worst thing in the world. It hurts like the dickens. I picked these up from Social Paintball down at World Cup last year. So these are, you know, $20-$25, something like that. And obviously I just like these because of the skeleton design. They are not really padded on the top. There's a little bit of padding on the bottom here, but it's mostly just to keep your hands just a little warm and take a little bit of sting out if you do get hit. This is a pod swab. So what happens a lot of times, once you go and get these pods, you fill them up, something happens, paint breaks in here. Well, once paint breaks in here, you don't want to put more paint in. If you put dirty paint in your hopper, that's bad. So you get one of these guys from Exalt for, I don't know, 10, 12 bucks, 15 bucks, something like that. And then you just get that in there and it cleans it right out. This thing, I believe you can take off here and throw it in the wash or something like that. Honestly, I've never had to. I don't know how it stays clean, but it stays clean in there. First aid kit, as I mentioned, things happen. You get a cut on your elbow, your knee, your face, whatever. It's always nice at least to have a few band-aids. Here's the red jersey that we have for the team. Oh, a hat. Okay, so some sort of a hat is nice. This is just an old Under Armour one that I had. I like this one because, you know, it's a little bit darker. I actually have a red hat that I used to wear for a long time, and people are like, dude, every time you poke your head out, it's like a beacon saying, shooting me. So I got this one because hopefully it will hide in the shadows a little bit more, but it serves two purposes. I only wear it once it starts to get cooler, because otherwise I really just can't stand it. So it keeps your head warm, keeps your ears warm. It allows your mask to stay on tighter. So I know a lot of people will wear these because when they sweat a lot, the mask sort of loses some grip and it provides more areas for your mask to grip onto. But it also helps when you get shot in the head, the back of the head, something like that. It takes a little bit of sting out. Again, you got a mask on there, but you can still get shot up here and it can still hurt pretty bad. So definitely get some sort of head thing to wear. And then, as I mentioned, for when I'm out there and it's super hot and I'm coaching the team, then I'll just wear this to keep the sun off my eyes. Let's see here. So the next thing here are my knee pads. So there's lots of different variations of knee pads that are out there. And I really like these from Carbon Paintball. First off, I like the feel of them. Most of them are neoprene. So if you've ever worn like a some sort of a ski suit that's full neoprene, that's what this feels like, all around the edges and then just the padding up front. But it's not like a hard padding. Like I can twist this and do all this stuff here. The important part of this is that it stays on my leg. Again, it's important to make sure that you get the right size. These are the largest. I know that they have a size chart on the Carbon website, so make sure that you measure your leg with a tape measure and get the right size. But again, I like these because of the neoprene, and I don't know if it's the neoprene that allows it to stay on or if it's the strap that's up top here. But it's super nice. Again, a lot of people I know, they're always pulling up on those knee pads during practice because they're sliding down. But these Carbon ones are great. The other thing that I have is just this little headband here. This one, I was an HK one. I think we got this down at World Cup last year. And this is mostly just a vanity item, okay? It does provide you with a little bit of protection, and I'm just gonna show you what that protection is here. So, here we go, can you see that? So this is what it looks like when you're wearing your mask, and you have this little extra bit of protection. So again, you're getting shot in the mask, you're gonna get shot up here as well. So there's different size headbands that people wear. This one is, I think to me, a good size. It's got this terry cloth on the back. I liked it because it has these ghost thingies from Pac-Man, the blinkies on there. So that's why I bought it. And let's see here. So here's another bag that I have. This is also a bag that I got on sale from A&S Gear, super cheap. And it's pretty rugged. So I got this to carry, I got another gun. So this is the GI/Planet Eclipse stealth marker. It comes with three different barrel sizes, and I really like this marker. If you want to take a look at that, then I'll provide a link. This is my original hopper that I got. This is the Rotor One. And this thing really is just a tank, man. It's super old, but it came with the kit that I bought for my my axe. And other than it being blue and just sort of sticking out, I love it because it's got this little trigger down here. And so if any balls tend to get stuck, you can pull this back and it unsticks it. So it came with the speed feed, which are these little white teeth on here already. So I can just drop the pods in there. So that all worked out great. Last year, this is the Ninja SL2 tank, I believe. No, just the SL. This is the Ninja SL tank here with the Pro V-Reg on top of it. I'm not sure if you really need to worry about this Pro V-Reg, really. The SL stands for super light. So this is a carbon fiber tank. That's the important part, is that it is light. Because as you're carrying these things around for, you know, hours at a time, and you happen to be poking out of a bunker or something like that, and you're holding it up, with all the paint and everything, it can get heavy. So if you're gonna invest in buying your own tank, I do recommend going ahead and getting your own carbon fiber tank. Ninja is sort of the name in tanks in paintball. So I felt like that was safe. Again, something I picked up off of eBay. I felt like that was safe to go with, but there's a lot of new great tanks that have come out lately. So be sure to check out the different ones. So, and then finally, this is my Virtue mask. This is the Ascent Aspect. This is something, this is the one that kind of is a little bit further away from your face. So here's what it looks like. Again, I was looking for something that was on the cheaper side of things. I think I bought this one Might have bought this also from eBay. I think Virtue has a, place where they go and sell their old stuff. And you can pick out the different color waves that you like. I do like the white and red, but it does tend to stick out a little bit. But it was a pretty good mask. I like it. I just like the EVSs a little bit better. But it's also great to have a backup mask if you're bringing a buddy along or your kids are bringing a buddy along and they don't have their own one. It's better to use this one every day, all day long, than it is to use whatever it is at your local rental shop. So it's always good to have these extras. That's why I have all this stuff, is because of the extras, because you know this stuff breaks, it's finicky, and it's better to have it than not have it. So that's everything that I have in my paintball gear bag for 2018. Be sure to watch out for future gear bag videos to see how things change going into 2019. Thanks for watching. Hope it helps. Remember to give a like for the video if you believe this helped you. If you want to see more content like this, then click the subscribe button and ding the little bell to make sure you get those notifications. Again, all of the products that I mentioned here are listed down in the description below with as many of the links that I can find. So thanks again for watching. Have a great day.